Today we're making a StarBeam themed bento box. Have an adult help you with this. First, I'm cooking some corn on the cob and hard boiling some eggs. I'm peeling the hard boiled eggs and setting it aside. I have some red cabbage I'm adding to boiling water and cooking for about 5 minutes. We're going to set this aside as well. Now I'm going to make some shrimp tempura. I'm peeling the outside shell off the shrimp and keeping the tail on. I'm making some cuts on the underside of the shrimp. We're going to bend it backwards to make it straight. I have some tempura batter and ice cold water. I'm going to mix it until smooth. Now coat the shrimp into the batter. Deep fry the shrimp until golden brown, about 2 to 3 minutes in neutral oil. The oil temperature should be at 340 to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. Transfer the shrimp tempura to a wire rack or a plate lined with paper towel to drain excess oil and set aside. Now I'm making StarBeam out of tuna onigiri. You'll need some canned tuna, a little bit of Japanese mayo, salt and pepper. Mix this well. To form the onigiri for StarBeam's head, I'm using saran wrap and we're gonna add some rice and top it with the tuna mixture right on top of the rice. And then rice right on top. We're gonna gently form a ball using the saran wrap. And there it is, we have our face. Now we're gonna make mini tuna onigiri balls for StarBeam's hair buns. We're going to do the same steps. Rice, a little bit of tuna, and rice on top, and using the saran wrap to gently form little mini balls. There we go, we have one hair bun, and now our second hair bun. Now I'm taking a slice of turkey and wrapping that around her face. To lay down the edges, all you have to do is take some scissors and make some cuts around the edge. And now we're gonna press it down. StarBeam has dark blue hair, so I'm using the red cabbage that we cooked earlier and some scissors, and I'm just gonna cut and form her hair. We're giving her a little haircut. We're going to do the same with StarBeam's mini hair buns. I'm just cutting some red cabbage, measuring it, and wrapping it up. To make it lay flat around the circles, I'm just making some slits around the side, and there it is. So cute. I love how the hair turned out with the cabbage. Now I have some ham. I'm gonna use an X-Acto knife. I'm going to cut out her mask. Make sure an adult is doing this for you. You can also use scissors to cut out your shapes. I'm gently adding the mask to her face. Now I'm using a star shape cutter, cutting out some stars for her hair clips. Moving on to StarBeam's facial features, I'm using some cheese for her eyes. I'm also using seaweed for all the details in her eyes. I'm using scissors to cut out circles. I'm using a little piece of cheese for the eyeballs and some more seaweed for the eyelashes. I cut a piece of cheese into a tiny little triangle for her nose. I'm using more seaweed for her mouth. I'm gonna use cheese for her teeth. We have completed StarBeam, so set her aside, and now we're gonna make Kipper. You're gonna need 2 eggs, one for Kipper's body and one for his wings. I'm using seaweed and a knife to cut out Kipper's eyebrows. I'm just sticking it right onto the egg. Now for his eyes. First, I'm cutting out circles, and then I'm gonna use a piece of those circles to make his eye shape. And now another 2 small circles for his eyeballs. I'm using a tiny piece of egg for the highlight in his eyes. I'm using a yellow bell pepper for his beak, and I'm also gonna use it for his feet. I made a little cut in the egg, and we're just gonna insert the bell pepper right into it. Same for the feet, I'm just gonna make little cuts, and we're gonna stick the feet right into the egg. So cute! I'm using the pieces from the other egg and cutting out his wings. I'm making it wavy on one side for his feathers, and then we're gonna add his feather details with the seaweed. And I stuck the seaweed right onto the egg. After making 2 wings, we're done with Kipper. I have a cantaloupe. I'm gonna slice it thin, and then using my star shape cutters, I'm cutting out stars. I'm using 3 different sizes. You can use other fruits that you'd like watermelon and honeydew melon, and make stars out of them. I'm lining my bento box with some lettuce and adding StarBeam, adding her hair. Next is Kipper. He came out so cute, adding him in and his little wings. In the middle, I'm adding our delicious shrimp tempura. I'm adding about 6 to 7 pieces and our bite-sized corn. And lastly, I'm adding our star cantaloupe fruit and some sour rainbow gummies to make it look like shooting stars. And ta-da, here is our StarBeam themed bento box. Enjoy!